camp is a dream that some friends and I had 5 years ago. And it's basically a youth development program that we run for 3 weeks on Harbour Island that has several different components. In the morning, we have a summer school, an academic summer school.
Their projects and their morning sessions are a little bit more thorough and geared more toward social activities and social change and, you know, stuff that they can, that impact their community.
The main part of it is the afternoon program, Space to Create. That's where we do dance, music, drama, and art and work towards a show that we put on for the community. The program aims to empower kids to develop their confidence, to develop their teamwork skills, and to develop their artistic talent.
Space's goals are centered around community.
The goal is to bring the children of Harbour Island together and to impact the community.
It's just to bring people together from different areas of the community to work towards a common goal, which is our show, and it always has a positive message and an inspiring message. And the big idea is just to take some kids off the streets for 3 weeks and make something good happen for them. So the program serves kids between the age of 6 and 16. And by the time you're over 14, you become what's called a counselor in training. So that's a separate program that focuses on leadership. They get to work along with the instructors, just help run things and learn and grow as leaders.
It's pretty fun. You get to help the children with their acting, their drama, their dance, their art. You get to be interactive with the counselors and have fun.
And I bring in instructors, professional artists. We have a chorister from England this year, a dance teacher from Toronto, an artist from England, a drama teacher from Toronto. And then we have local volunteers and artists from the community who they partner with, and they run a workshop for 3 weeks. And at the end of the 3 weeks, we have a big presentation in the backyard over there with all the kids' families, different people from the community, and it's a really inspiring day. Every dance, every skit, every song is chosen and thought about, and we ask the kids to think about the message that they're communicating. So we want them to think about the fact that if you're dancing to a song and the lyrics of that song are expressing a positive message, you're saying something to people, you're inspiring them through your art. It's a way you can communicate. Whether it's learning in the morning, art, music, drama in the afternoon, or even playing dodgeball in the yard, where they're doing all these activities with a focus on empowering themselves to make good decisions and empowering the community to say how the kids have something to offer, you know? They're not a burden on the community. The kids are something that we should invest in, and they're capable of solving some of these issues that we struggle as adults to deal with.
Kids start asking about camp in September, and camp is in August, so that's how much they love it.
You see kids on the street all through the year, here, and the only thing they remember about you is that you're from space.
I know the kids love the camp because as soon as camp closes, they say, Mr. Will, when are we having camp again?
So when does space start? When does space start?
At Christmas in January, I'll drive past school. Mr. Will, we having camp this summer? I can come?
I think they love it. That's why they keep coming back.
It's become a tradition for them. Some of the kids who are now helping us run the camp came in as campers 5 years ago. They were like 8 years old. Now they're young teenagers, and it's been incredible to watch them grow. I step out of the ordinary. I can feel my soul ascend.